So good morning all of you. So today we will learn about how to calculate the reservoir capacity with the help of the mass curve. So our point is calculation of reservoir capacity. By mass curve. So firstly, we can see about what is mean by reservoir. So reservoir, it is nothing but the water body formed due to construction of obstruction on across the river. Suppose this is the river, right, flowing in this direction. So across this that river, if we construct any obstruction in the form of dam, in the form of weir, in the form of barrage. So due to construction of this obstruction, the flow of river get obstructed and there is a formation of water body on the upstream side, and such a water body is known as reservoir. So this is upstream side of my reservoir, this is downstream side. That is, the upstream side is nothing but the side on which water gets stored or reservoir is formed, and the downstream side is nothing but the water is discharged with the help of this sluiceway or any outlet. So our point is calculation of reservoir capacity by using mass curve. So mass curve, it is the curve prepared from the flood hydrograph. That is mainly mass curve, it is nothing but the accumulated rainfall, so accumulated inflow into the reservoir with respect to time. That is, accumulated inflow on the y-axis. And time on the x axis. Mainly this time should be considered in years. This is for the data of several years can be taken, and from that the mass curve is prepared. So this mass curve is prepared from the flood hydrograph. So firstly we can say about hydrograph. This flood hydrograph or inflow hydrograph. So again, this flood hydrograph is inflow on a y-axis in meter cube or hectare meter, and time in years on a x-axis. Suppose consider the inflow curve, that is hydrograph curve, for a period 1991, 1992, 1993, 1994, then 1995. Suppose you have considered this flood hydrograph for a 5 years. So this is the variation of flood hydrograph. That is, the inflow during the initial period is minimum. Suppose is about 100 meter cube, then goes on increasing, then there is a less inflow coming due to, suppose there is summer season, then again it is increasing, rainy season, then decreases, then increase. So this is the variation of a flood hydrograph, right? Flood hydrograph. Flood hydrograph is nothing but simply the curve prepared by knowing the inflow coming into the reservoir at a several year, right? So from that flood hydrograph we have to prepare our mass curve, mass inflow curve. So mass curve is prepared just by adding the cumulative inflow of the years. That is, you have to create the accumulated inflow. So here from this same curve, the accumulated inflow can be taken on a y-axis and time in years on a x-axis. So same years are taken. Suppose we are starting from 1991, then 1992, 1993, 1994, and 1995. Right? These are the 5 years. So for that 5 years, we have to prepare the mass curve from this flood hydrograph, right? So suppose at initial stage in 1991 the inflow is zero, we have considered inflow zero, then it is adding, then goes on increasing. So this is the variation of a mass curve. Here this mass curve is always a rising curve because we have considered the accumulated inflow, that is we are at the this inflow of a particular or of a consecutive year. This cumulative inflow can be added to obtain the accumulated inflow in meter cube or in a hectare meter. Many hectare meter, it is the hectare, it is the unit of an area. This one hectare meter is equal to 10^4 meter square, right? So here after getting this mass inflow curve, we have to prepare the demand curve. So demand curve, it is nothing but the curve prepared by knowing the amount of the water discharged from the reservoir as per the demand or as per the requirement. And this demand curve again, accumulated demand is taken, accumulated demand. So again it is a always rising curve, accumulated demand. That is mainly this demand curve is prepared for a 1 year. This 1 year span is taken because the demand may be similar, somewhat similar in the year, every year. So here, in which year the maximum water can be discharged? This such a year can be taken. Suppose in 1993 the water is discharged more than the remaining years. So this year can be considered 1994. This is the 1 year period. And again, it is the accumulated demand. So it is rising curve. So variation of this demand curve may be a straight line or may be a curve. A straight line in variation is obtained if there is a constant supply of water from the reservoir. And the curve variation may be when there is no constant supply of water from the reservoir. So to calculate the reservoir capacity by using mass curve, also by using the demand curve. So firstly, mark the highest point. In this mass curve, suppose this highest point are A1, A2 and A3. A1, A2 and A3, right? Then next, draw the tangent from this highest point A1, A2, A3, and this tangent may be parallel to demand curve. So for calculation purpose, we can consider demand curve is the straight line. There is constant discharge from the reservoir. So here draw this tangent which is parallel to the demand curve from this highest point. Because this is the first tangent which is parallel to demand curve. This is second tangent and suppose this is the third tangent. The variation is this line. Right? So here this is the gap between this mass curve and the demand curve. So suppose draw the horizontal line from this highest point. Suppose this is the first horizontal line, then second horizontal line, and suppose this is the third horizontal line. Right? So here, this is the lowermost point of a mass curve. So name it as B1. Then again, B2 and B3. Then draw the vertical line from point B1 as well as from B2 as well as from B3. Right? What we have done till now? We have prepared the mass curve from the flood hydrograph just by adding the cumulative inflows to prepare the accumulated inflow. Right? And from that we have marked the highest point of that mass curve. Then drawing the tangent from the highest point, this tangent will be parallel to demand curve. So here next we have drawn the horizontal line from the highest point. Also we have marked the lower point of a mass curve such as B1, B2, B3, and from that B1, B2, B3 we have drawn the vertical line. Suppose this vertical line intersects at a tangent drawn at point C1, then C2 and C3. Also, this horizontal line, this vertical line intersects the horizontal line at point D1, D2 and D3. Right? This is the graph we created with the help of hydrograph, with the help of demand curve, right? So here, this A1 D1 is nothing but the time, right? Time. So for that time, we have to supply the water is about C1 D1. This is the requirement, this is the demand. C1 D1 is the demand. But here, B1 D1. This is the time, this is demand, and this is B1 D1. This is nothing but the inflow. Inflow into the reservoir. But we have to supply the water C1 D1, it is the amount. But there is only B1 D1. This amount of the water can be inflowed, that can be turning into the reservoir. So we have to supply the water, this B1 C1 extra water, from the storage capacity. From the storage capacity, already stored water into the reservoir. So this water can be discharged from the reservoir to fulfill the demand, this C1 D1. So similarly here, this D2 P2 is the inflow, and here P2 C2 is the extra water can be supplied from the storage. Again this B3 C3, right? So here extra water supplied is nothing but B1 C1, right? Then next B2 C2, then B3 C3. So this is the extra water supplied from the storage of the reservoir. Suppose in B1 C1 we have supplied about 720 water, B2 C2 is about 600, and suppose this is 770 meter cube water, extra water we have supplied, right? So here maximum among these three quantities we have taken to describe the storage capacity required. So here maximum water supplied in third is in B3 C3, about 770 meter cube. So this is the required storage capacity into the reservoir to fulfill the required demand. So this is the simple way to find out the what is the storage capacity, what is the amount of the water which can be stored into the reservoir to fulfill the demand during dry period. That is, if there is a less inflow coming into the reservoir, there is no rainfall into the catchment area, so we have to supply the water. We have to supply the water whether it is a rainfall is coming or not. So this supply can be discharged from the storage of the reservoir, right? From the useful storage. So this amount of the water can be stored. 770 meter cube water can be, this is the minimum amount of water can be stored into the reservoir to fulfill the demand. So this is about calculation of the reservoir capacity from the reservoir. So thank you.